Going.
Alright, Shalom. We the Hebrew Israelites who come here every week to prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom. But first and foremost, we'd like to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory unto the Heavenly Father.
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai,
Ba'ashem, Hakadash,
Ba'ashem, Hakadash.
Double honor unto the apostles, the elders of Great Millstone, the well, and the brothers of truth. So the days to be sincere, Achim out there that are your fellow laborers and that believe in Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai. To the future sisters, you also believe in Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Shalom. Yeah, man. So you can jump off with, yeah, you start up. I was thinking about something else now, man. Because, you know, Esau, the so-called white man, he's the one that is ruling right now. And he's ruling this earth, you know, in total wickedness, man. And now, you know, we all know that everyone, you know, needs to take the jab, you know, that poison. And Esau, you know, he's taking away all your liberties, man. And he's crushing the people. Now, can you get that in Proverbs 15, verse 13? You know, this devil is, can you get Revelation 12, 12? He's ruling this earth in total wickedness, and he's oppressing the people. And if you go to, a few days ago, the president of France, you know, ladron, as I call it, you know, and that means thief, you know, if I'm correct, also in Spanish, but in, you know, the language of the Antilles, especially on Curacao, you know, it means thief. And that's what these people are, man. These people are thieves from the jump, man. As soon as they got into power, they started to steal everything, man. Even our identity, you know, all the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. And how do they do that? Through their television, you know, their live vision, basically, you know. Through the media, man, which goes back to the goddess of illusion. And that's how they indoctrinate all the people into believing that they are, you know, the ones that are the epitome of beauty, and that they are the Most High and the Son and the angels, you know, and the prophets. But these people, it's nonsense, man. They claim to be everyone except who the Bible says they are, man. That's the damn devil, the so-called white man, Esau. So,
very hard to make it cheerful confidence, but by sorrow the heart and the spirit is broken.
Yeah, man, so these people know what they're doing, man. And if you read it again, very hard to make it cheerful confidence. If you see the people now, you see that they are broken down, man. And as soon as I think about it, I start laughing, you know. We all laugh, man, because we see the downfall of our enemy, man. And if you can get that as Mark 25, verse 7. So, you know, we start, you know, laughing and seeing that our enemies are in vain, man. You know, and the spoil is getting closer to it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
man, our rulership is coming. It's, you know, it's nigh, man. Because our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, who is a so-called black man, you know, and so-called Negro, is coming back, man, for his people. And a lot of people, you know, you need to get this through your thick head, that this world is not going to endure forever. So if you take this damn jab or whatever, you know, it's not going to, make your life better. It's not going to prolong this whole state. And these devils also, they think by pushing these laws by mandating their wicked laws and their, you know, dumbass plans, they think that they're really gonna rule, man. They really think that they're gonna rule forever, which is something that they ain't gonna do, man. You know, can you get that Psalm 49 and 11 or so? Just hold the song. Oh, yeah, can read it real quick. Then I'm gonna jump in the Proverbs again and get to some words, man.
Well, this is the book of Proverbs, chapter 15, verse 13. Merry heart make it a cheerful confidence, but by sorrow the heart of the spirit is broken.
Yeah, man, so if you read articles like President Macron, he said that he's gonna make the people who are not poisoned up, he's gonna make their life hell, you know. He's gonna, and the funny thing is, you use the word merde, which goes into shit. But the funny thing is that the scriptures speak about this guy is gonna be, you know, can you go to Job 20? and you can start at verse 3. A few things pop in my mind, jumping around a bit, but y'all decide, man, it's going to be edifying, man. That's how the Spirit moves. When you think about things, you want to, you know, get scriptures with it, man. That's how we speak, man. You know, again, you know, Isaiah 8 and 20. You know, that's what it is, man. So, let me know. But the thing is that each of us really pushing this most of the people. Because a lot of people, they talk to us like, yeah, but yes, you know, yes, there's propaganda from other countries. Even though it came out of the devil's mouth himself, man. That's the funny thing, you know. Some people you just can't convince, man. You know, they are stuck on stupid, man. Stuck in La La Land, man. You know, they have, you know, they lead, what is that thing called? Cognitive dissonance, man. Mm-hmm. If you look that up, it goes into you being confronted with something that is so mind-blowing to you, you know, so terrible to your, and it really bursts your bubble. So you stick your hand into the sand, man, and then, you know, or with like an ostrich, like boom, an ostrich. You know, mm-hmm. you're trying to hide yourself from the world, but the world is still, if there's something going on in here, people come running up here and you stick your hand in the sand, are those people going to go away? No, man. They're going to kick you right in the ass, man. You know, or you know, slice you from the neck. You know, since your head is in the sand, you're still gone, man. People can't face the truth, man. Because you know what? They can't handle the truth, man. As Jack Nicholson said, man. And we have fun with it, man. Again, it's a very beautiful thing for us to see these devils going down, man, and you know, circling down the drain. You know, they're done, man. Yeah. They're done. Can you read the
Job?
Yeah, the Sirach.
Yeah, the Sirach.
Yeah, and then jump to the Job.
Sirach 7, eh?
No, 25 and 7. And there it shows you also, and that's also something that Esau took, man. He took that and put it. Nekona, man, the barbarian, the warrior, what was named that barbarian, man? You know?
You read? This is Sirach, chapter 25, verse 7. There be 9 things which I have judged in my heart to be heavy, and then I will order my with my tongue a man that had joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy.
You see, so that something. If you see the downfall of your enemy, that's something really beautiful to the one that is suffering under that devil, man. In this case, you know, Esau, man. You know, and let me get into that quote of Conan. And they asked him, what's best in life? You know? And it states, and he answered, to crush your enemies, to see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentations of the women. And lamentation is when you are in woe and in sadness and sorrow, man. You know? Oh, my husband, my baby, you know? Mm-hmm. Why? You know, crying and shit, that's music to our ears, man. Because why? Look at this place, man. It's a damn dunghill, man. Everything is messed up, the whole earth is polluted, and the stupidest thing is that these people, they rule this earth, and what do? They spray the whole freaking earth, you know, the skies with all types of chemicals, man. You know, with barium and aluminum. If you put that together, you know, the scientific name or the code or whatever you want to name it, of barium is BA and of aluminum is AL. So that spells Baal, man. So that shows you who these devils are worshiping, man. They do everything with the spiritual no thought behind it, man, but on the left hand side. You know, because they serve Satan. They're the ones that are really wicked as men. They're all in the fucking in the rain, with the wind blazing, with a mask on, man. You have fresh air out here, and still people are afraid, man. Watch till the Most High really, you know, unleashes something deadly that you will drop dead from, man. You know? Yahweh Tzah, man. And Yahweh Tzah, we will be protected from that, man. Because the scriptures speak about it. A lot of people gonna die left and right, man. Literally, man. These people got something coming, man. So again, if you see the fall of your enemies, it's like, you know, it is being compared, but hey, there's two things now. Your the ninth and the tenth thing, can you read it again?
Karma. This is Sirach chapter 25, verse 7. There be nine things which I have judged in my heart to be happy, and the tenth I will honor with my tongue. A man that had joy of his children.
So if you have joy of your children, that's a very joyous thing unto, you know, a man. And of course, if you are a family, it's very beautiful to enjoy your children, because you see something of yourself and you see something, you know, that's so small. It's funny, man. It's very, you know, and a child gives you that pure, you know, that unconditional love, man. You really see that your child loves you, and that's you can't compare it with nothing, man. You know, so that's a very beautiful thing. And see the pure joy in a child, you know, and the innocence of a child. That's why the Lord also said, you know, you need to become like a child, man. You know, become the innocent, cleanse yourself, basically, become pure again. Like the Apostle Ramla often said, like a child, he is close to the spirit world, man. So they have a connection with spiritual things also. If they see things or whatever, you know, they tend to notice things also, man. So you need to become like a child again and wipe all that bullshit that you have been taught in Christian church or whatever you've been following, you know, and come to the Lord again, man, and learn again, man. So to jump back to this, to see the fall of your enemy is a very joyous thing, man, you know. We'll finish it. Apart from enjoying your children, of course, man. But yeah.
A man that have had joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy.
Yeah, man, and that's what we're waiting for, man. Yahweh Tzav, man. What, like the Lord says, so there be some of you standing here that will not see death or not taste of death, man. And that's what we want. We want to live and see the fall of our enemies, man. To see the Lord return and to get His vengeance on, man. Because the day of vengeance is also in the Lord's heart. Don't forget about that, man.
Of Psalms 37:7. Remember, O children of Edom, in the day of Jerusalem, He said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof.
Yeah, man, they want to destroy and ruin it, man. You know? And that's what the same spirit that they have today, man. They enjoy what they see.
Stones.
Yeah, man, so it's gonna be a beautiful thing to, you know, in the beginning when I read this, you know, that's their babies against the stones, man. Hey, that's some hardcore shit, man. That shows you that you're angry, man. That shows you that you really have a hatred towards these people, man. Because you know when you're gonna hate someone, when you are for peace, you know, can you get that in coming in your land, coming with hatred, coming with deceit, basically, and then showing the hatred, man, and rape, robbing, and murdering everyone you know, man. You know, including babies, like they did to the so-called Native American Indians, man. All the atrocities that Esau has, shown over there, all the murder that he has committed, all the pedophile acts, the sodomite acts, you know. He needs to pay for that still, man. But what does he do? You know, they made treaties like more than 500.
Yeah.
And all of them were broken, man. You know, they came with a lot of deceit and with, you know, they just don't regard anything that doesn't have any connection to them, you know, as being their race. Even their own race, they're showing hatred towards, man. So what if you are the one that is endangering their prolonging, man, the prolonging of their kingdom, you know? He wants to get rid of you first, man. And he will make sure that he will get rid of you, man. So he has that perpetual hatred in him, man. You know, since the days of Cain and Abel, you know, that malignant spirit, that hateful, poisonous spirit is still in these people, man. You know, Cain slew Abel because the Most High was not pleased, you know, with the sacrifice that Cain gave, man. You know, that hatred, that jealousy, that jumped on, Esau, man, the same spirit, man. You know, and that's in these people today, man, because Esau is the progenitor of the so-called Caucasus, man. So, yeah, can you read that? If you have something, you just do
120?
Yeah, and 27, of 120, and what was it?
Yeah, 127, yeah.
And Dana 140, yeah.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 120, verse 7. I am for peace, but when I speak, they are for war.
Yeah, man. Can you jump to Psalms 55? And yeah, please.
This is the Ezekiel chapter 25, verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword, and in the time of their calamity, in the time of their iniquity, at the end. Therefore, as I live, said the Lord, power, I will bear thee on the blood, and blood shall pursue thee.
Yeah, man, because these devils, you know, they have a perpetual hatred, perpetual scar on, man. It's like, you know, they always draw you have like a symbol that looks like an eight. You know, it's ongoing, infinity, basically, man. And that's what they have, man. You know, infinitive hatred, man, or basically ongoing hatred towards our people, man. You know, even towards the Most High, if we read Psalm 83, you know, they want to cut off our name out of remembrance, man. That's why they hate everything, because these people know who we are, man. They know who we are, man. And if we would have known who we were from the from the beginning, or we would have kept our identity, you would have not be really suffering on this devil. Because if you know that you are the ones that Moses led to the Red Sea, you know, if you know that you are a royal nation, you know, one that is a part of a nation that is going to rule over everyone and is going to receive spiritual power, we are with the South Lord winning. You're going to be like, man, it's like giving a child punishment and then you want to use a PlayStation and you know, they can't even chew and everything, you know, after you whoop his ass, man.
You have everything right there, you know. You know?
Yeah, you have a telephone or whatever. Come on, man. So, the Most High better lose the way through these devils, man. And it's our own fault because we us and the Most High and us, man, because we went off, man. So the Most High, he punished us for that, man.
From heaven, what you say. And the Most High always give warnings, you know. That's why we, nowadays, from the Elder Apostles on down, we are on the streets, you know. And the Most High did it every time. He warned our people, like, hey, if you don't, if you stop worshipping these other powers and stuff, you know, you need to stop it, otherwise, you know, even warn us for this. But our people didn't want to listen. Until this day, still our people don't want to listen.
That's right. You had something?
Yeah, the Psalms 55.
Yeah.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 55.
Were you reading or were you?
I was with Ezekiel and I have Job and Lamentation.
Okay.
It's the book of Psalms. It's the book of Psalms, chapter 55. And let me start at verse 20. He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He had broken his covenant. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
Yeah, these people, you know, can you start again?
This one, yeah. So, this book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 20. He had put forth his hand against such as be at peace with him. He had broken his covenant.
Yes, see, so that's how Esau crept up in the Americas, man. You know, he was received there, and what did this devil do? He came with predator, man. You know, first he came with God, of course, so got interested because he was scoping out the place, man.
Saw that gold.
He saw that our brothers were playing with gold, you know, and how they were with, you know, in tune with nature, and they had it going on. Here you have some filthy scumbags coming from Spain, coming from Europe, not bathing, you know, being all filthy, you know, bringing diseases and all that shit. And you see the total opposite, man. People were intrigued by what they saw over there, man. You know, kind of.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
Yeah, man. So he came with smooth talking, man. But war was in his heart, and that's what the devil does. He's very good in, you know, stabbing people while so-called being nice or being nicely dressed, but yet he's coming there for the kill, man. Not for the murder. I must correct myself, man. Because a kill, if you put a sodomite to death, that's killing. Because that's a righteous killing, man.
Don't say the Bible.
Don't say the scriptures, man. You know, so we, yeah, man, now, so we know that. So, you know, according to the scriptures, you can do that, man. Because these damn sodomites that are ruling over here, you know, they ain't even supposed to be in the seat of rulership, man. But that's how you see that, as the scriptures say, you know, as the judges are the people, you know, because he sets up people that are like-minded too, man. And he puts that that filthy sodomite, you know, dirty-ass energy out there, man. That dirty vibration puts that out. Like, you know what? Since they be bombarded with it now, they be like, you know what? I'm just, you know what? Basically, you know, they consent with the abortion, man. So they accept it. Now it's so-called normal. It ain't normal, man. If someone goes up, someone's just fucking behind, you know, it causes diseases. Your behind is not going to function like it's supposed to be functioning, man. It's an exit, not an entrance, man. Even with a female, you should not be doing that. But scriptures tell you that, you know, you have a natural use in the book of Romans, man. So that's a natural use. That's something that, you know, gets moist and goes deeply when you put it into the builder. You know, that's what it is, man. You know, it tingles. When she sees you, she's already ready, you know? That's how it is. That's how it is, man. You know, now with all types of shit that you have to do, that's what they do. And it sounds fucked up, but it is fucked up, man. You need to know that, man. People are being desensitized and into, you know, accepting all types of abominations, man. But yeah, man.
His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords.
Yeah, man, yet where they drawn swords, man, softer than oil. Oil is what you put on, man. It's soft. You know, but this devil is being compared with his smoothness is like oil, man. But yet we're the drawn swords. So they come out in a smooth way. Oh yeah, I'm so interested in this. Oh, they can look at this. Hey, yeah, come and look at this. Oh, that's amazing. Oh yeah, how do you see that in your language? That's how they
amigo,
you know, that's what they do, man.
Jake always falls for them, man.
Yeah. Hey, man.
He's so nice.
Yeah, man. They always try to pull a fast one on you, man. Mm-hmm.
Some of them are brutal. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, man. This is incredible, man.
But I used to have an afro too, you know. Showing pictures and shit. We be looking at this guy, man, for what's going on, man. You know?
Some dude when we went to hardware, you know, with the Afro, man, some guy in the store, you know, some
Afro, like, yeah, I used to have an Afro too, man.
But a few minutes ago, you were trying to double cross, you were upping the price for 50% higher, you know what I'm saying? Until you hit you with some numbers, then there's zoom, and then you wanted to show pictures and everything. Yeah, that's like, how the devil is, man. You know, and after that is you're gonna be, you know, vanishing, man. Yeah, man. Can you get that in the job, Tony? From verse 3 for the boy with 3.
This is Job.
8 to 9 or something, man.
This is Job, chapter 20, verse 3. I have heard the check of my reproach, and the spirit of my understanding caused me to answer. Knowest thou not this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a
short time. I mean, the triumph of the hypocrite and of the joy of the wicked is but for a short time, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a short time. You know, give me a totally bullshit, man.
Job 20, verse 5. That the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite what for a moment.
Yeah, man, so they might be running right now, they don't have the problem. You know, running now, you know, they have the problem running up the stairs, you know, burning hard, you know, they feel burning hard, you know, their big heart, you know, ain't working like that, you know, and now with all the jabs, you know, everything grabbing the chest. There's a lot of people, man,
supporters.
Hey, yeah, man, feel this. Also grab is just, you know, football players, you know, it's a lot of people.
Can I add something? Yeah, yesterday also, I see, was a news reporter, yesterday also, he was reporting somewhere in east of Europe, and he fell down, he was like,
oh, no, yeah, no,
you
I,
see,
I put it in the chat.
Oh, you put it in the chat.
From Portugal, from...
Yeah, so, yeah, exactly.
That shit was funny, man. That was really funny.
Yeah, he was like,
Yeah, man. Comeback was a Portuguese.
Yeah, it was Portuguese. Salakia,
Man. Yeah, man. And yeah, that's what you have right now, man. People have, you know, all them, you know, poison up in the system in the running. And don't forget, man,
Esau has also these beautiful towers for you, man. Placed around the globe, man. In the town, in the city, in the street near you. Or maybe on top of your building, man.
Yeah.
You know, and he puts that shit on, and, you know, everything connects, man. Even the 5G by itself is, you know, by itself is good enough to get you through some things, man. Birds are dropping dead. There was another article that a brother posted in the chat. Yeah, birds be dropping dead and shit. You know, don't forget about that, man. Bees are dropping dead. A lot of people getting nauseous, they're getting the headaches, and that's all these, you know, the side effects or the effects of, you know, the 5G radiation, man. So a lot of people are getting sicker and sicker, and that's why we need the Lord, man. We need Yahweh Bashan Yahushai, man. Because I'm thinking, like, the last few months I have been sick, I don't know how many times, man. And people in my family and brothers also, man, they get sick, you know. But hey, that's how you, of course, the Most High lets you go through certain things, and it also builds up a certain spirit in, you know, inside you, man. That this world is not, you know, it's not our rest, man. You can have money, you can have a good job or whatever. Most I be hooking us up lately, man. Hey, it's crazy. Other people be losing their businesses, we be getting businesses, man. But yet, you know, when you sit down and think, it's all fucking vanity, man. Vanity, vanity, all is vanity, is what the scriptures say, man. Because you can have money, you can have a dope car, whatever. You have the most expensive clothing, whatever you have, man. Even a family. You know, it's beautiful and all that, but look around you, man. You're still in this shit hole, man. You're still in the world that's being governed by sodomites, by wicked people that worship Satan, you know? And look at you funny when you speak the truth, man. You know? And they're still not being punished for all the wickedness that they have done, man. Yet you can't say anything about the freaking Holocaust, you know? But that's being bombarded on television. Oh, look at what they did, man. You know? While it's all freaking nonsense. Take a look at Leopold II, man. What he did to Jake in the Congo, man. What he did to the people over there, chopping off hands of children, of whoever, man, that didn't meet the quota of the day, man.
Just for fun.
Yeah, man. Because that's how the devil is, man. If you take a look at certain things that they did with the so-called Native Americans, man, with the Reubenites and with the Gadites, man. Mm-hmm. You know? Take a look what they did unto them, man. And how are they treating the tribe of Issachar today, man? Of whom they stole their country, man. That used to be all up in LA, you know, I don't know if you have the whole coast.
We went all the way to San Diego.
Hey, it's theirs, man. It's that whole damn country is from, it belongs to the 10 tribes, man. You know? Yeah, man. Yeah, and then you want to build a wall and have the audacity to say to the Mexican president, you're going to build a wall, yeah. And you're going to pay for it, you know, like Trump said a few years ago, man.
I also think that there was a war, but you know, like when the so-called Mexican were crossing the borders, they would separate the parents from the children,
yeah,
and put them in
ice.
Isolate them and put them in holding cells.
Yeah, man.
That's what it is.
You straight up in these detention camps, man. That's already how you see that, these people, they don't show favor to people, to young people, to the world, man. And that goes straight to the, that goes straight into the curses.
So, chapter 26, open His Excellency mount up to the heavens, and His hand reach up to the clouds, yet He shall perish forever. Like his own dog.
Yeah, man, so, you know, the funny thing is, here you have Macron talking about, he wants to vex the people and, shit people. But who's going to be, like, shit people the globe? Who's going to be perishing like his own shit? You know? He's going to disappear, man. And that's the funny part. So the things that you are wishing for other people, it's gonna befall yourself, man, and your people, man. That's the funny part, man. So you're gonna be vanishing, man. Come, read.
You want a piece over here?
Yeah, you and then we jump back.
Yeah. This Obadiah, verse 9. And thy mighty man, O demon, shall be dismayed, to the end that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter.
Scientists, you know, and the boss said, you know, tomorrow is like like it's Germany, man. With all them intelligent people, you know, them Ashausen, you know, all the people that make them devices, you know, all the Nazis that fled to, or that were basically put in Argentina, you know, and that were used by these Americans, you know, to develop their technology. It's gonna be all a thing of the past, man. You know, you will be cut off by slaughter, thus say the Bible, man. Because you've been, like the brother said, you know, since thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall be sold in the school of hate blood. So you're gonna get what you want, right? Come, read.
Verse 10, for thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee.
Yeah, man, and that's what you're seeing right now. What is happening now? Can you jump to verse 10 and Job 20 and 10?
This is Job chapter 20, verse 10. His children shall seek to please the poor, and his hand shall restore their goods.
Yeah, man, so his children shall seek to please the poor. Yeah, Black Lives Matter. Yeah, Francine, we're going to the Black Lives Matter today, you know? They're just looking for dick, man. That's one thing. And the other one, yeah, man, I had some female way back, also from here somewhere, man. You know, I talked to her, you know, I need to be, I talked to her and she was like, yeah, my girlfriend's, are you down with that movement? I said, like, nah, I'm not down with it, you know. First of all, I'm not black, you know, I'm brown. You know, you have my coat that's like black, and you see, if you go to the crayon box, it's not what I told her, but, you know, I did say I'm not down with the Black Lives Matter movement, because, you know, it's really like going to someone, it's like, oh, please help me, boop, 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 and I don't believe in that, man. Of course, we know we believe in Yahweh Basham Yahushua, but I was just like, nah, man, I'm not down with that movement, man. You go out on the streets, you go and be in scrimmages and all types of bullshit. For what, man? To be looked at as a clown, like, look at these blacks. They have nothing to us. Look at them begging us. You know, basically, I want to say some fucked up shit.
Can I add something? The headlines of Black Lives Matter thing is sponsored by an advertiser. Your sorrows, you know, man. So it is always in the hands of these devils, man. So, yeah, man.
That's what it is, man. It's all run by Soros, man. Same thing with the Antifa and all that shit, man. They put puppets left and right and make you fight for their enjoyment, man. Mm-hmm. And that shows you who, if you have a garden, you know. Yeah, it's for them, man. It's entertainment, man. They have the world in their hands right now. So if you go out and you be like, hey, you know, no justice, no peace, no justice, no peace. And then, to a man that bring it wicked, you know, can you read Psalm 94, verse 20? Why are you gonna beg a serpent? You know? Please, oh, please, serpent, please come to the face of the serpent. Please help me, please. You know, no justice, no peace. You're gonna get bitten in the face, man. And all the people laugh at you, man.
Psalm 94, verse 20. Shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by law?
Yeah,
by
a
law, Salakim.
Yeah, my soul, keep reading it.
Shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by a law?
Yeah, man, so these people, you know, shall they have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by law? They come with wickedness. They put it in law, man. So they think about something, you know, they plaster one wicked law with the other, and they have a whole wicked system right there for you, man. Sodomites are allowed to adopt children, to be together, to marry, you know. Certain people that don't want them to marry them, now you have them, oh, they are, how did they say it, weigerers, you don't want to do this. You can have your you know, yeah, you can have penalties for that too, man.
You're phobic.
Yeah, man, so-called phobic. I'm not, I, you know, yeah, people that are have arachnophobia, they're scared of their spiders. But, you know, that is the same character as, you know, homophobia. What the hell is that? I'm disgusted with it. That's what it is, man. It's just like, you know, with Lot, man. Vexed by the filthy conversation of the wicked and by what he was seeing, man. That's what it is, man. It is frustrating. And these devils, they know that. Because there was one book, I forgot what book it was, if it was from Albert Pike or another, that said that, you know, they were talking about all their plans. And one of the plans was to flood, you know, to let these sodomites loose, basically, to corrupt the minds of these people, man. You know, they are breaking, and by doing that, what are you also doing? Putting meal with meal, what does that create? Nothing. Nothing but diseases, nothing but wicked spirits. You know, it's like a discotheque for fucking demons, man. You open up the doors, hey, everyone can come in, man. You too, come in. You know, all them demons be like, shoot. You know, jumping on these people. Why? Because they do ritualistic acts, you know, by doing these sodomite thing, you know, these abominable acts, man. You're opening up the your vessels, basically, for more demons. And that's how you get... Something that's happy, or you know, if you have gay clothing according to the scriptures, that's something that is, you know, beautiful of costly apparel, man.
To back you up, concerning the gay clothing.
Come.
It's the book of James, chapter 2, verse 3. And ye have respect to him that weareth the gay clothing, and say unto him, sit thou here in a good place, and say to the poor, stand thou there, or sit here on the body.
Yeah, man, because a lot of people have respect for persons. They see someone with a fancy outfit, or they be like, hey, come see him, man. Don't sit with that, man. They boss. You know? Who does that remind you of, by the way, man? You know? Like IYC, man, I just call it, you know, as they say, the beast by the name of, what is that?
Yeah, name the animal by the name, yeah. The beast by the name.
Yeah, that's what they say in the Dutch, yeah, man.
Yeah.
You just pinpoint.
Call it how it is.
Yeah, man, it's just, yeah, man, that's what it is, man.
You know? Beast by the name.
Yeah, man. And you are like a beast if you are, you know, going away from the Lord's and commandments, man. And being filthy, man. Having no rules, no moral standards. You know, you're like a beast, man. So, if you go here to the word gay, goes to lampros in the Greek, it goes into shining, brilliant, clear, transparent. It goes into splendid, you know, magnificent, splendid. Splendid things, i.e. luxuries or elegancies in dress or style. So you come with the splendid clothing, man, you know? You come with costly apparel, basically, you know, costly apparel, beautiful apparel, you know? And figuratively, let me see, magnificent, sumptuous in appearance. Let me go into that word real quick and look it up. The meaning of sumptuous is lush, luxuriant, you know, so you get the luxurious, you get the point, rich, wealthy. That's what it is, basically, it's almost synonymous for that.
So, what was I saying? Yeah, these people, these sodomites, they proud as shit, man. And they get backed up by the government. And if you say something against it, then you are in trouble, man. According to their wicked laws, man. You know, that's why, Psalms 94 states, like, these people, they have nothing to do with Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, man. You know? And then if you can keep, do you still have the 94, Psalm 94?
Psalm 94.
You can keep reading, because they're gonna get what they deserve, man.
Verse 20. Shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by law? By a law, they gather themselves together against the soul of the righteous, and condemn the innocent blood.
Yeah, man. So these people are the throne of iniquity, man. So iniquity is sin upon sin upon sin, man. Doing all types of wickedness, and they wear the crown doing that shit, man. You know, and that's not a compliment, man. If you wear a crown, people think, like, oh yeah, that's great. You know? But if you're a wicked piece of shit, you know, if you're the best in doing wicked or infamous, you know, for doing wicked, that's not a compliment, man. Because the Most High hates sin, he hates sinners, man. Yes, the Most High hates, according to the scriptures, man. He hates sinners, he's dead, the mighty person said, Jacob have I loved, and Esau have I hated. Yeah, that's what he said. I know this damn rock, man. His head already flew off, man. But it is what it is, man. The Most High hates. The God of the Bible hates. He hates wickedness, he hates the Edomites, the so-called Caucasians, man. And he loves his people, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. You know, and if you be more specific, he loves the ones that are doing his will, man. Because the rest of them are acting like these damn heathens, man. Making leagues with them, man. Please, give us a peace. You know, we it's just like in the book of Maccabees, man. People go to shit, go to hell for a moment, and ready to fold and be a traitor and go to the damn devil, asking for some mercy and for a nice cozy place where you can get you can do your dirt. You know, while Esau's extortionate, extorting you. Everything that you have, man, slowly, but yet you think you own something. You own nothing in this world, man. You know? So, yeah.
Yeah. First, I'll start with 21 again. This is Psalms chapter 49, verse 21. They gather themselves together against the soul of the righteous and condemn the innocent blood. But the Lord is my defense, and my power is the rock of my refuge, and he shall bring upon them their own iniquity and shall cut them off.
Yeah, man, so all the wickedness that these devils have been doing, they shall be cut off, and all the wickedness that you continue doing, you're gonna be rewarded for that, man. But you can get a reward, you're gonna get something for what you have done. Same thing with us, man. If we fuck up, man, we go in the world and we do all types of wickedness, the Most High's gonna get you a reward too, man. But not one you're gonna like. Yeah, Rico.
This is the book of Revelation chapter 22, verse 12. And behold, I will bring you, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be.
Yeah, man, so you're gonna be rewarded according to what you have done for Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, man. So if you put out your best according to your gift, because the Most High, everyone has his talent. And all this is better, certain things, think about it, man. But yet,
That's why it's important to be together with like-minded men. You know, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there in the midst, man. That's why it's important to fellowship with brethren, man. You know, you can, if you can't be there, you can still call. You can still, you know, talk to WhatsApp or whatever, man. You know, and that's how you can, you know, fellowship, man. It's very important to not forsake the assemblies of each other, basically of yourselves. You know, being together with like-minded men, because that keeps you, of course, your heart is out, Lord, the Most High willing, in the spirit, man. You know, you can talk about different things. You know, things that you've been through. You know, you can get advice of how to handle certain things in your daily life. You know, because this is something that the scriptures teach us, also how to conduct ourselves. You know, in this you know, when you go to your job, when you are at home, you know, when you go to some shit. You know, the scriptures show you everything that you need to be shown to the spirit. So it's very important, man.
As the body is one, he had many members, and the members of that one body, being many, are one body also in Yahushua.
Yeah, man, that's the beauty, man. You know, the body has many members, man. You know, you have the thumb, chop your thumb off, man. Let's see how it goes, man. You know, or your big toe, where your balance is going to be, you know? Certain parts of the body are very, they might not be commonly, as the scriptures also say, but yet they're very important, man. So you shouldn't be looking down upon other parts of the body, man. They are very important. You know, you might not just see it yet, but it's better to keep that thought for yourself, man. You know, because you might offend someone that you shouldn't be offending. You shouldn't be offending a brother to begin with, but you don't know how the Most High is looking at that man. You know, how the Most High loves that man, you know? And yet you'll be there, you know, sowing discord by being unbrotherly, man. The Lord told us to love the Heavenly Father with all your heart, with all your might, and to love your neighbor, man. And to treat your neighbor like you want to be treated. Then you're going to be, you know, thinking about things twice, man, before you utter certain things, or before you, you know, do certain things, man, unto someone else. Or it can also be in a positive sense, of course. You know, if someone needs help and you've been through some shit, you think about how you felt and you don't want that feeling to continue for that brother, or you don't want your brother to be in that predicament, so you're going to help him out, you know?
Because
so, the Most High can help you. Manya. Somebody. So, yeah, so certain things that the Most High might hook you up so you can help someone else out, man. But if he sees that you're stingy and whatever, you know, tight fists as they say, you know, then the Most High can get you out of that position and give it to someone else, man. You know, you need to help each other out, man. But yet also communication is very important concerning that, man, because you can't always, you know, you see certain things, but also communication from people that are in the gym need to, you know, that needs to be on point as well, man, so you can help each other out before it fucking blows up and everyone is in that shit, you know? So, yeah, man. You had some more?
No, that was it. Okay. What you was talking about.
Yeah, that was a good one, man. Good, man. Yeah, man.
Peters?
No, all types of topics come to the Philippians, you know, I was thinking about, you know, in the very short verse, man.
A little bit further when you was talking about the food, the thumb, if you cut off your thumb.
Yeah, yeah, that's why.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
you want to go in there, go in
yeah,
there, man.
Yeah, I'll go in.
Can you get the Philippians and very short verses and
come, this is 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13. For by one spirit we are all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles.
Yeah, man, don't get it twisted. You know, it's all about the children of Israel, man.
That's right.
Because if you go to
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1.
Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away unto these dumb idols, even as ye were led.
Yeah, but so that is what made us Gentiles, man. You know, it started in the book of Matthew, man, where a lot of people wanted to be like these other nations that went to a king in that time, and yet Antiochus Epiphanes ruling in that time. And that, you know, that piece of shit, he went overboard with it, man. He didn't allow us to keep the Shabbat, you know, to circumcise the children, you know? And that's what you get, man. He wanted all to become one. That's what the Matthew says, man, in the first chapter. Again, does this sound familiar, man? That's the same thing that Klaus Schwab is, advocating, and our politicians around the globe are advocating the same thing, man. You know, build back better. That's what they say. But that, because the NWO, that's kind of played out. Everyone knows, like, oh, NWO, they get triggered. It's a fun. That's funny because Esau always uses trigger words to get people in a certain mindset. And now NWO is like, hey, that's the damn Illuminati. You know, them fuck you, Rothschild. They get angry, man. They go. You have clips of, you know, people walking up to these people, man. And that's funny, because in the scriptures, man, certain things, can you get Job 34, verse 18? And, just to go ahead and quit.
With what you were saying, can I add to it?
Yeah.
Like you were saying, he was saying also that the world is just going to have much more anger.
Yeah, man. Like, what is necessary?
Yeah,
we will own nothing, and we have it.
And we have it.
Yeah,
and,
man.
And you posted it also, and I saw it also yesterday. I saw the clip of that guy who went to Siegfried Castle. With the torch.
Yeah.
Hey,
Siegfried Castle.
I'm gonna call it Siegfried Castle.
Siegfried Castle.
Siegfried Castle.
It's cheese.
Yeah, man. It's cheese. You know, there's one of these politicians that was also deep into this in the World Economic Forum, if I'm correct, right?
Yeah.
She's a board member. About the info, man. That was good information, man. You know, you can see it on the website. That's, her name is right there, man.
Yeah, man.
And she's, like, internationally, she's well, so-called educated in this system, man. Speaks multiple languages and all that, man. So, she is everywhere, and, you know, now she was all of a sudden the number two party, but we all saw it coming, man. So that she will become the number two, Rutte will be number one, you know, and now they're going to rule again. While the whole freaking Netherlands hates these people, man, or the most of them, because you have some bozos that still upload videos that say, yeah, you see the contamination rates of today, you know, 25,400 or something, or 24,500 or something, you know, it's because you did not get your poison yet. I'm like, dude, if you have your poison 3 times, 4 times, you boost it up now, right? You know, you look, you have your shit going in the body, you know, your heart going boom, 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 you know? Still. You looking at other people, man. While you are in the car, with your screen on, with your mask on, with your latex gloves on, with your windows up, you know, with 3 shots in your arm, with the booster, still you're looking at other people. While that brings you to that tweet, you know, because you had a Jake that he had a tweet. Because people were saying things like that, like, hey, how could that be, boom, 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 should not be like this, and what was it, was some Jake that said, if you still need a booster after being fully poisoned up, and still need to get tested after being fully poisoned up with that blood, and still need to wear a mask after being fully poisoned up, and still get hospitalized after being fully poisoned up. It's probably time that you admit that you've been conned, you know? And that's what it is, man, you know? That's funny to me, man.
Hey, when you were, that's the spirit, you was talking about and that dude over there, he was looking at you with the mask, he was like, oh shit.
That tall dude.
Can you get from
yeah,
14
can I add
and from 14?
What you just said, because I also had an, like, he's the cousin of my father, you know. So he also called my mother and he said that he felt very sorry that he took the jabs, you know. Because they, you know, they're talking about you need the booster, and they already said like this year you also gotta have two more shots, you know. So you feel really fucked up. So my mother like, yeah, he's really stressed.
Yeah, man. That's just what it is, man. People, they are being, you know, some of them, of course, like the brother also said before camp. You know, it was given unto them to see the world, man. That's because they're in the basement. They have so many people, man. But the ones that see, you know, in ears to ear, you know, in the spirit, they gonna see what's going on with people.
This is Proverbs chapter 14, verse 15. The simple believe it every word, but the prudent man looketh well up his going.
God, you know, if you can read it again, then we'll go to the word simple, man.
God. This is Proverbs chapter 14, verse 15. The simple believes in every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going.
Yeah, man, so the simple believe in every word, man. If you go to the word simple, it goes into simplicity, simple, foolish, and open-minded. So if you are open-minded...
No, you are. No, I'm not totally against it, man.
You're naive, man. You're stupid, man. You know?
You know,
you're thinking of all types of other things. In some cases, you need to, judge certain things. But to be open-minded, like, I'm not really against it. If you know something's bad, but still you're trying to force something in your mind to be like,
oh, well, it's not that bad. You know, we all die anyway.
You're stupid, man. You're stupid. So simple, foolish, open-minded, silly, you know, foolish again. How many times do we have to hear the word fool, man? It's one time, two, you're silly, you know? So it's enough, man, for a wise man to know that, hey, this thing, you've been stung multiple times now. People were dying. People were fainting on the television. It does not... People, scientists even say like, hey man, this damn thing ain't even that serious, man. If you take a look at the, let's just only take a look at the numbers. Almost 25,000 that are, you know, of that day. Why would you be afraid? There's 70 million people here, man. What's 25,000? And they are not dying, man. They catching a cold or whatever, man. You know? And then they're not all in the damn hospital because, you know, that's another BS story that they tell, man. You know? And the funny thing is, they say even down in the south, like a few months ago, one of them, the heads of the hospital said, like, it's 8 out of 10 on the IC were fully jabbed up, man, at that time, man. So what you talking about, man? And they say that on the TV. You have now doctors coming up, lawyers come up with podcasts, and they getting mad because people say, I'm leaving the damn, you know, that Ishmaelite or that Salafia, that Amalekite Jew, man. You know, Israeli Jew, or however you want to call it, man. Yeah, man, we can't say that word.
We can't say that here, man.
Yeah, we are the Jews, man.
Yeah,
you know?
Before they go, man, we need to cut the video, man.
You know, that's how they do, man. That's, you see how fucking annoying that is, man. You can't even say what you want, you know? And that's, you say,
hey, this the land of the free, you know? We have the
first of the Second Amendment, you know? You can speak freedom of speech or whatever, the right to bear arms, you know? You can be damn fucking Rambo and whatever, man. You can say whatever the hell you want, as long as you put the American flag in the back, you know? You can just show your patriotism and whatever you want. You can speak freely. We are America, son. You know? Why are we speaking on things that, through the book that you claim to be loving? You know? But you're according to this word, right? It's your book, right? Why would you be against people that preach the Bible, man, that preach the truth. Why? You know, because you are bending the truth and you're not of the truth. The only thing that is correct is that, yeah, you're in the scriptures, but not in the way that you like. And that's why you're against this word, man, you know? But you see that people, their channels are being chopped off, man, and that's why they go to BitChute, they go to Rumble,
Odyssey.
They go to Odyssey now, because there, you know, you can't see the things you ought to see. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, man.
You know, you can't go to other channels to check out what you need to be checking on, man. Without this channel of this the content is linked to of the channel that's linked to this content is now deleted or whatever. You know what YouTube a lot of times you know states. You can't even really speak, man.
Can I say something? What you were saying is right. Because yesterday, I followed Jake. You know, he got good content like things. Protesting all over the world, and also about, you know, the Jabberwocky.
Yeah.
And he was on a live yesterday. He was cussing the tube. You know, he was like, "Hey man, they don't want to cuss. He got 50k subscribers. It's not even tube like us, you know, but he got 50k subscribers." And he was like, "Hey man, this is bullshit." Yeah, but if I made, and he made a good point, because you always say that, like he said, like, hey, but if I made about the wolf or, you know, rappers getting killed and Negroes killing each other, you monetize it. You said, that's okay, you know, you don't give the dogs up, you know, but then you get money and you get commercials on your channel, man. But if you, like, our channels, they deem it, like, it is harmful.
Misinformation,
harmful.
Yeah, man.
Medical.
You have to put 18 plus or whatever. It's not suitable for children. You know, what did the Lord say, man? Suffer not the children to come out of you, man. But that's what y'all devils are doing, and you're gonna pay for that too, man. So it doesn't matter how you twist or turn it. It's coming on your neck, man. You know. So hey, for us, it's of course it's very frustrating, but we also accept that this is part of the truth, man. That's the famine of the word, man. Book of Amos speaks about that, man. Amos 8:11. So hey, it is what it is, man. But yet going through the process, it's also building up that hatred towards these devils, man. Even on the road, on the way here, you know, on the road, I was like, hey, man, can you imagine, man, if you hit the road, or you in the air, you know, you in the skies, in the chariot, you know, at the time. You know, if you think about it now. But I said then, on the road, that's a lot of stress out the window, a lot of frustration out the window, because these people, they drive like a bunch of idiots, man. They are causing accidents for nothing, man. They're a bunch of, and they're on the road, man, the same jumping on these people, and they're jumping in front of the cars like five.
Yeah,
I don't know, man.
Nothing, man.
I took my glasses, and, you know, some lady was like this, you know, big ass car. You know, I was like, yeah, you need them, you know? Damn, man, that's horrible, man. These people, man, it's a bunch of base men, and they set free, man. They're a bunch of animals out there just you know, making a total mess of this whole earth, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's not because they dress nice or whatever that they are so-called sophisticated and, you know,
it's like 2 meters long, man. Generally, man.
Proverbs 22 and 3. The Proverbs,
this is the book of Proverbs. Chapter 22, verse 3. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished.
Yeah, man, so a prudent man, he foresees the evil, man. You're going, you know, if you're wise, you know, prudent is, you know, going into, if you're wise, you're going to check things out, man. Scopeo, man. Look around, man. You need to be circumspect, man. Especially in these last days, man. You cannot be just like, oh, yeah. The back of the label, and you know, check what's you know, at the back of it, man, of your drinks, of your food, you know, you will be amazed, man. Esau got, you know, I'm like, what the fuck is this, man? You look it up, it's like, yeah, it's a metal, you know, derived from, of is this derived from a metal or derived from wood, you know, things from wood, and I'm like, what are y'all doing, man? So, I'm like, what are y'all doing? What are you putting in the food, man? Come on, what are you doing, hey? You know, these people are poisoning your children, man. They have fucking aspartame in, you had, back in the days, you had Flintstone, you know, Flintstone vitamins. They had aspartame in that shit, man. And that's how you see that the devil, that's another example of how he comes, you know, smooth as oil. You know, he packs, he puts a nice package, you know, bright colors, put the Flintstones on it, you know. Mm-hmm. Y'all remember doing all that, man. Your children, you didn't look like, mama, I want that. You get it? Mm-hmm. Child, you know, you're feeding your child freaking rat poison, man. Mm-hmm. Aspartame is something that, you know, kills rats. And that's how Esau takes it, looks, you know, basically is scaling you, man. Like you're damn vermin. You're nothing but a rat to vermin. You need to be get rid of, man. Exterminated. You know? Huh?
Yeah. Yeah. They also do it with a lot of lemonades that you put water with it. You know, yeah, yeah, yeah. Water.
Yeah.
They
yeah.
also do it with a lot of those also. You had like very known brands. Yeah, back in the days, like Iraq and stuff, you know,
uh-huh.
Those brands, they also used, I don't know if they still put it, but a lot of them still are, but there was also one, they also used to put that in it, you know.
Yeah,
Aspartame and Asuflan. Yeah.
I think the Wiki, man. The Wiki too also, the yeah. Wiki had it, Wiki.
They also had it?
No, Wiki did.
I don't know about that, man.
Wiki's good now.
Yeah, man, the fluoride.
I always check those things out.
Yeah, man, you have them, man, but that's the scripture, man, that's the book of Ezekiel, man, you have it? Oh, I thought you were going to it. Oh, yeah, not the scripture? Oh, you were checking your piece of wrong. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. So, you know, a prudent man, physique, you can get it as you can for and that's why, we keep reading again. A prudent man, physique, the evil man.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 3. A prudent man, physique, the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished.
Yeah, man. So, if you... Let me go into the word also. To the simple, pass on. Again, the foolish, the naive, the open-minded, you know, they just like, oh, what the hell, you know? And then, now you're punished. Now you be like, you know, passing out while you reporting the news, man. Yeah, or grabbing your heart. You want to get, you know, you need to, you know, get this trophy, man. Oh, yeah, just put another shot in it, you know? You know, you have Djokovic, you know, public enemy number one. You know, that tennis player, because he's a big guy. Now they said the boys had, you know, get still end. And he doesn't, because that's, you know, your personal privacy. Information, man. Mm-hmm. That's privacy issues right there, man, mm-hmm. that are being, you know, Esau wants to, you know, invade your privacy, man. Yet he's telling you like, no, we can't do that. But later, you know, he's doing everything that he said. That's why you can't never trust the devil, man.
So, you know?
Yeah, man, that's what I was in my mind.
Yeah, man, that's what this devil is doing, man. Was it Proverbs 22:23?
Yeah.
So a prudent man, prudent goes into sensible, also sly, sensible, crafty, let me see, cunning. Prudent goes into acting with or showing care and thought for the future, you know, and it also goes in well judged, wise, you know, if you're well judged, showing careful consideration or much skill, you know, so wise, having or showing experience, knowledge and good judgment. So that's how you see that, you know, in these things you need to be a good judge as well, and you need to take a look at what happened. Who is the one that is trying to help me? Because you have Bill Gates, the man that came, that so-called came with IBM, which I don't believe a word of that shit. Because all these devils steal, they've been doing it, so why not now? Then you have a computer, but it's so sensitive for viruses, because this devil is the one that is unleashing all that shit, man. Because who's the one in power, man? Take a look at that, man.
It's the biggest virus, man.
And now you have this man, you know, that is saying that he's going to help you, because he's investing in all these companies that have to do with these, you know, with these points of poison. And now he's the one that tries to help you. Why, he can't even give me a normal computer without freaking viruses coming left and right. He can't even come with a good antivirus, but he's the genius billionaire that builds with all these computers, man. Now I want to put my life in his hands. That's something that, you know, you should think about, man. You know, that's why you need to be, you know, judging this whole situation in a correct manner. You need to take a look at who's the one that is pushing this. Why are they pushing this? Why are they giving you $100? Why are you receiving a raffle ticket to win a car, which is, was in Russia, a car of 10,000 euros? Man, at least give a Mercedes or something, man. Add it. You know, a good car, man. You know, or a car, you know, that is almost the equivalent of what Putin has, man, of the same brand, man.
Exactly.
You know, give me something that's good, man. But these devils, they give you a free beer. You had Governor Cuomo. Jabs. He was like, jabs. Why do you guys, man? You get discounts. Pushing that so hard, yet, take it, Job 13 and 4. Yet, if you take a look at the world, let's take a look at cancer. Mm-hmm. Who are the ones that are putting all these carcinogens in food? Who, and the funny thing is, if you take a look at what the health, they're showing you hog farms and all the fumes that cause people to get cancer. And yet, if you take a look at all these so-called charities, what are they providing? What kind of diet advice are they giving? A lot of meat, a lot of carcinogen-filled diets, man. And that's what was showed in this documentary. So Esau is keeping you in that vicious cycle of going from the, you know, bad diet to the doctor, to the hospital, to a lot of medication. You know, and if you don't die off, you go back to the same thing. That's why, you know, you read that?
It's the book of Job, chapter 13 and 4. But ye are forgers of lies, ye are all physicians of no value.
Yeah, man, you are forgers of lies, but you blast a lie upon lie upon lie. You come with all types of wickedness. You put it in the King of Job 4 and 16 and 17. You put it in a nice, to marketing, you know, with the blonde female, with white teeth.
you know, which is also most of them are fake, you know, to begin with. Hair colors fake, makeup fake up, you know, fake ass teeth, you know, all types of you know, beautiful so-called surroundings, you know, happy children, you know, playing around. Those are the ones that are getting you the deadliest of the deadliest medicines. And yet, in the small, in the head of voice, might cause anal bleeding, this, that, you know, brain tumors, blah, 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 you know? But yet, they're saying it's good for you.
And the answer, last year, the beginning of this year, I made a video about it. They had it for the children on YouTube. You have children on YouTube?
Yeah, yeah.
You know? And they made a video, like, Bill Gates. They said Bill Gates, he's the philanthropist, and without Bill Gates and without Warren Buffett, this world wouldn't exist. Yeah. And everybody was going crazy on Twitter, like, what the hell is this, man? You know, they was like, wait, this is crazy, and they pulled it away immediately. But I got the footage, you know, so yeah. If some archive want it, I still can send it. Yeah. And they brainwashing your children, man, like, yeah. Hey. Without Bill Gates, this world couldn't exist, and Warren Buffett. But they are devils, man.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. That's what it is. And they know.
You still have problems in it?
Try to win 4, but train up the child. Yeah. And also, then you can jump to Saul.
Train up your child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it.
Yeah, you know why? That is the reason. If you teach your children the scriptures, you know, you're building up, you're planting that seed, man. And you harvest the sun, you know, your child will not, you know, depart from the heart of Hashem, Yahushua. You teach them the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man. You know, this word is building up a solid foundation. Within your child, man, is stabilizing their spirit, man. Because this foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, you know, as the scriptures say. But if you open his eyes and you teach him the scriptures, that will depart, man. You know, Yahweh is out again. It's all by the will of Yahweh, by Shem Yahushai, man. But do you read the Psalm 105? Very important to teach the scriptures. Why? Because these devils, when they get their claws on your child, they're teaching them all these lies, man. Yep. They're teaching them that Santa Claus is real. They're teaching them that, you know, you can be a girl while you are a boy, you know. They're teaching you that sodomites are normal. They bring in damn freaking cross-dressers to your school or to your local library to go with the children that are young. But yet, they are not allowed to go clubbing, or to drink alcohol, or to buy alcohol. They fucking, these people ask me, for, you know, for my ID, when I go and buy myself a bottle of wine, man, you know? Just, hey, man, just by thinking of it, I need a bottle of wine. No, man, I'm just kidding. But, you know, it's just, you know, foolishness, man. It's totally... You can have, you know, all these hormonal, you can have a hormonal treatment starting like from 12 years and up. But yet, you know, so basically you can already start with the sex change as a child, but yet you can't go into a certain, you know, you can't sign certain things because you're a child. You can't buy certain things in the store because you're a child. What else? You can't watch certain movies because you are a child, but you can't change your sex while you are a child. You see what these people are doing, man. It's total confusion, man. These devils need to be eradicated, man. That's why they need to go, man. They are they are very heavy in witchcraft, very heavy in pedophilia, very heavy in rape, robbing, and murdering, man. That's what they are doing, man. Their own people are crying, man. Their own people are dying because of them, their own people. Their own people are the Edomites, man. You know? So they hate their own people evil, man. I have already said it, evil. They hate their own people.
out the facts, man. We checking the same things or more things that you're checking. And sometimes it's the same thing, but we checking out and we see what's happening, man. Because we have eyes to see, man. You don't know what's up, man. And for now, you see multiple people, one thousand people, they go out, and now it's world news that you get your ass whooped, bit off, you know, your tail bit off by some police dog, you know, while you are there. Yeah, man, it is what it is, man. Shake your tail feather. Now you get your tail bit off, man. By a police dog, which it went over the globe, because Candace Owens was speaking about it. Yeah. And she is like busy with the American media and the presidents, but now she's talking about the damn peon devil that get his ass bit and his arm chewed off, chewed on his arm by a police canine, like, man. That's what it is, man.
Yeah, man.
You hear the bone cracking, man. You hear the bone cracking.
Necrophilia, yeah. Some people have illness, so yeah, if they want. What?
Yeah, do you know what it is?
Was that case with the female and mother? Someone that did something to a dead body of a mother. And
Asian-Euro guy.
Exactly,
he was not punished. He reacted on it.
Yeah, and he said that I put multiple lawyers on that case, mm-hmm. which elderly female, her corpse was, basically ran through by that damn demonic infested devil of 18 years old or something to, around that age. If I'm correct, it was 18. And Huffhaus was saying like, hey, we don't have really laws that pinpoint this situation. I put multiple lawyers on it and they don't really see, something that we really can, like, okay, this is it and we can handle it by this. But there's other things that we can do, so we're not gonna do anything with it. And the same thing, he didn't take a pedophile manual out of someone. He didn't take a pedophile manual or book out of circulation. Yeah. That's another thing that he also didn't do, because this guy is in that system, man. All these judges, all these politicians and these people that are in so-called high places, they do things that you will be ashamed of speaking about them in light, man. It's very satanic, it's very filthy. They are busy with a lot of sodomy about the sacrifice of children. That's what they do, man. That's why you had the whole of Bernard coming out with all these Jungle Tree, verse
tree.
Yeah, man. Let me just jump on continue. Expose is definitely his wicked spirit, man. We the Habakkuk 2, verse 4.
Book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, 4. Behold, their soul which is lifted up is not upright. Behold, their soul which is lifted up is not upright in him.
Yeah, man. So behold, this soul which is lifted up is very proud. You know?
Huh? It's not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith.
Yeah, man, so these devils, they are not upright, man. They are not righteous. They are wicked people, man. As soon as they keep on speaking lies, man, oh, we can't do anything against this. These devils, they have their laws, but yet they don't punish these people when they need to be punished, man. These pedophiles, they can keep going on, man. When something is being exposed, they have a fall guy like Mark Batou back in the days that covered for all of these devils. And now you have the case of this Madame, so-called, you know, what was it, Ghislaine Maxwell?
Yeah.
You know? What about her, man? Now they say like, yeah, because of some juror, member of the jury was speaking stupid things. Endangering the judgment or whatever. You know, so they always have some tricks to cover up their damn devils, man. You know, they always will cover for themselves, man, because there's a lot of people that are, you know, connected with this damn Epstein case, man. There's a lot of people that were on these flight logs, man. A lot of celebrities, man. Is in damn trouble?
No.
You've been confronted with it wherever you turn, man. But what about Prince, you know, the Prince Andrew, man? What about, you know, why not go into that case? Now you have like, what was it? I don't know if they work on this, falling asleep or whatever.
But they said that R. Kelly is the worst of the worst. Mm. He's worse than Epstein and Andrew.
Charlie Sheen,
exactly.
That's horrible, man. Charlie Sheen was popping little boys in the behind, man.
Yeah, man.
And Jake for the series.
Yeah, man.
It's so cool.
And not only Corey Heyman or whatever, and that other guy, man. Corey Feldman and another Corey, right?
Yeah, the other Corey.
Yeah, man, that's also playing the game because he wants to see money before he can unleash certain names or whatever. Shit, fuck you, cool, man. You know, but we all know that that damn Charlie Sheen is also a damn pedophile and a damn Satanist, man.
With the stagger blood.
Yeah, man. That's why they get that big check, man. And now you have people like Richard Priestrat first, man.
Psalms chapter 73 verse 5. They are not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men.
Yeah, very good, man. Very good precept, man. Man. You can continue, man. These people are not in trouble as other men. Why? They put up the system, man. It's for them. You know? They have their own food, basically, man. Or basically, woofoo. Buy us, fuck you. That's all what they think when they sign these laws, man. Because you had the G7. You had like a video when all these so-called world leaders, their kings, so-called, they came together.
oh, chopping it up, blah, 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 yeah.
But when the camera went on, boom, distance. You know, yeah, so yeah. And still people fall for it, man. Still people fall for these tricks, man. Because the media puts on such a strong illusion. That's why the one guy of the CIA or the FBI said that's the biggest tool that they have, man, to get people's mind where they want it to be, man. Even Bush was saying it with the 9/11 propaganda, you know. Repeat until people believe it. He just said it on camera, man, because he knows after the soldiers have seen him saying this, and he's, you know, and you'll be watching your 8 o'clock news or 6 o'clock news with your plate full of abomination on your lap, you still gonna believe what they're gonna do. This all you're gonna eat. What you gonna eat, the abomination plus the abomination in the spirit, man. And that's how they create you in the, you know, your docile self to one that is fitting their society, man. To be a damn coin and be a slave and to be someone that just labors and goes back to their freaking crib, man. That's just what it is, man. That's how Esau wants you, man. Not thinking, just going from check to check. Go home. Eat your abomination, drink your beer, whatever, you know, beat on your wife, or do whatever, you know. Drink your poison, go back to bed, you know, with cigarette butt, you know, almost enlightening you know, your freaking sheets. And the next morning, you know, you go out of your bed, without the shower, you know. You know, jump in the car, and then you see your foreman coming on. Then you see your foreman. Hey, that's the same guy that had the you know, the cigarette in his hand, all that, man. These base men. That's how they want people to live, man. That's what it is, man. But yeah, man, that was a good scripture, man. Staying out of trouble as other men. They made the laws, man. So they be like, you know what? They throw up a sign in the courtroom, you know, showing that they are part of the club, you know, the Lions Club, you know, these bases, you know. Yeah. They put the hand, you know, the hidden hand, the hand in the chest, or, the, you know, you have certain claws that they make with the hands, boom. You know, it's okay, yeah, throw that, just, this is Francis' son, man, you know, boom, 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 you know. Or Frankie, your son, or whatever. Not even that. What did they have? They have these names, man. I can't even think about certain things. But you know, they have certain Edomite names. You can fill it in yourself. They have bloodlines. They even show what supposed to show you this in the new series of Power. Now, certain. Don't you know who I am? You know, these people that wreak havoc in college and they get away with everything because their parents, you know, they build the pool, they build a part of the library. That's how it is, man. Mm-hmm. And that's where they start to also, you know, they mold these people in these colleges, man. Boy Scouts. Yeah, man, Boy Scouts as well, man. That's another place where, you know, if you send your child there, yeah, you need to think twice because that's also where a lot of these, you know, weird ass men grow on your children, man.
Sitting on the left, big dummy, man. Jake is lost, but he's sitting there.
Psalms chapter 73, verse 6. Therefore, pride compares them about as a chain. Violence covered them as a garment. The eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than heart could wish.
Yeah, man. Can you get Job 21? And that's. This shows you that it's their world, man. They build this this system according to their liking. Their eyes stand out with fatness. Like in the cartoons, you have these big, fat Edomites in suits, butters all, you know? Their eyes are bulging out. They, you know, you see them fat, sloppy people still eating like a pig, man. That's basically what they have, man. Their pockets are bulging because they have their businesses on top, man. You know, for one of all things, you need to go to these devils, man. If you have a business and you have a building, who are you paying taxes to? You know?
Even if you are a heathen, you know, if you are so-called Chinese or so-called, Arabian, who do they need to pay, man? The so-called white man. Who do you need to, whose money do you use? Whose face is well known around the globe? You know, whose money you use in international business? It's the dollar, man. Mm. You know? And that all goes back to these Americans, you know? It all goes back to the war, man. They're the ones that everyone is following after, man. You know? Huh?
Oh, yeah.
Finish it off. Verse 8. They are corrupt and speak wickedly concerning oppression. They speak lustily.
Yeah, man, you can't leave that out. They are corrupt. I need to prove it again. You know, they are corrupt, man. You know, concerning oppression, they be like, they speak lustily. You know, they look down upon, you know, the rest, man. They don't give a damn, man.
Book of Psalms chapter 73 verse 8. They are corrupt and speak wickedly concerning oppression, they speak loftily.
Yeah, so these people, if they see something going on, they're like, ah, get over it, man. They don't know. The slavery was a long time ago, but you know, yeah, if something's going on with them, we need to forget. Like our older brother also said, why don't you forgive and forget him? You know, why don't you forgive and forget, so-called, what was his name, Bin Laden,
yeah.
You know? Why don't you forget everything that happened during 9/11, man? Well, how can you say that? That's just preposterous. How can you? You just need to be locked up. You're an extremist, you know? How about all of these people that have suffered? You know, they're the people that, you know, orchestrated the whole shit to go back to the Holy Land and to freaking defile it, man. 1947, the Balfour Declaration, man. People went there by design, man.
Mm-hmm.
Hitler kicked them out because they came with immoral shit, man. Mm-hmm. Porno, all that's wickedness, man. Like they're doing right now. This is what you want, you know? So that's why, you know, these devils need to be eradicated, man. You know, they are the lowest of the lowest, and that spirit reflects, you know, out in this world, man. And this is what you get. Everything polluted, children being doing things. You see so many, if you go on Instagram, man, so many young females, she's like 15 or something, with the titties out and whatever, being a fucking slut on Instagram, man.
Can you say this about that? I saw yesterday, I was free, so I had some television time checking out Seppin and RTLV. RTLV, they said talking about children in group 8, like 6th graders, they're already sharing naked pictures between each other.
Yeah, man, I was supposed to post that,
yeah,
man.
That's
what
I said, man.
Yeah, man. It's even younger, if I'm correct, man.
They might, but they, yeah.
From 7 years old.
Yeah.
7 years
yeah,
old,
man.
Yeah.
It was younger,
it was from
man.
The elementary school.
It's crazy,
elementary
man.
School,
yeah. Yeah,
but they all need to have a phone, so you know.
Hey, but this is what you get. Can I say something?
Oh, yeah.
It was going viral, and everybody was talking shame about it from Holland. They had a naked show for children.
Yeah.
Yeah, you made a video about it. That's why, man, and that's why.
It's already been pushed out by the yet adults standing naked in front of children,
exactly,
from the classroom, and then they can ask questions concerning their bodies. Yet even teachers doing that and stuff.
Yeah, man. Yeah. That's why you get these things, man. Because the children, they copy it from what they see. Like, oh, this is normal.
Yeah.
Like the brother was saying, like, hey, this is normal. All these sodomite things, all these wicked things, you know.
Mm.
It's abomination, man, for your children. And your children don't need to see that.
Yeah.
You know, your children need to be children, man. Children need to be walking around, chilling, you know. Mm. Don't have to see naked shows of grown folks walking around naked. Mm. It's wickedness, man. That's why this kingdom is going to go down, man.
That's right,
really
yeah.
soon, man.
Yeah.
Because it is wicked.
Yeah, man. Here, it's online shaming. Let me put the translation on it. It's RTL News. This is one of the biggest mainstream news outlets. And broadcast in Holland. It says online shaming. And if you're seven here in the Netherlands, it's like you're like around 10, you know? Yeah, man, around 10 years old, elementary school. So, group 7 children already sharing nude photos with each other, man. At a young age, children share nude photos of peers with each other. It concerns children of 10, 11, it's not 12, because if you're in group 7, if you're 12, you're going to mid school, man.
Yeah, that's true.
So these devils trying to soften the blow, man. And it is also 10, 11, and 12 years old from group 7 and 8 of primary school. And it's crazy, man. Messed up. More than 400 teachers were asked about their experience with online shaming and with basically unwanted spreading of intimate photos and clips. And almost 100 of them had experiences with this at their schools. So that's almost 25% of them. And some children, they were undressed in front of a webcam, and they were recorded, you know. So and they spread those images. But why would you have that, man? And other children were filmed, you know, sneakily while going at camp or to camp or whatever, man. And this is something that is that's great. Why is it great? It's fucked up. Even when I say this, like a bit, like, yeah, it is fucked up, but why? The curses are reversing, man. You know, can you get the Deuteronomy 30:7? I'm gonna look this one up. And can you get the Amos 7? Verse 17, 7 verse 17. You can read?
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verse 7. Yehovah, thy power, put all these curses upon thy enemies and on them that hate thee, which persecute thee.
Yeah, man, so you see, people hate us as well, man. You know, so all these curses that are in Deuteronomy 28 from verse 15 to 68. So all these curses will be put upon our enemies, you know, upon them that hate thee, you know, and that have persecuted thee. And also, all these people that have inflicted all these perils upon us, you know, that have put us in slavery, you know, laughed, you know, scorned at us, mocked at us, man, you know, that have a hand in our downfall. And that's the funny thing for us now, because, you know, those who sold in tears, still, you know, open mind. Yeah, maybe it will still, maybe the fifth one or the fourth one will help. Yeah, it will help you near to your grave, man. That's what it's going to help you with. Can you read that?
Maybe you wanted to get something? Yeah, Amos.
This is Amos, chapter 7, verse 17. Therefore, thus said the Lord, thy wife shall be a harlot in the city, and the sons and thy daughters shall fall by the sword.
Yeah, man, so this gonna come upon y'all, man. You know, your wife shall be a harlot, even your daughters, man. Because the scriptures say there shall be no war nor sodomite in the nation of Israel, man.
So in the children of Israel, so that's gonna happen unto you, man.
You know, because you are putting out platforms for our daughters and our sons to be, you know, totally brain polluted because it's not washing. Because washing is cleaning, man. You're polluting it into being damn sodomites and being praised for it as well, man. Getting higher, better jobs, man. You know, getting rewarded when you are in the industry, man. You get bigger contracts. You know, if people say something, the people that are rightfully saying something against it are being punished for it, man. So you are being punished for righteous judgment, man. And that's how you see that judgment is turned upside down, man. It's all backwards in this whole world, man. Because wicked people that are on the left-hand side, following Satan, are at the seat of worship right now, man. They need to get kicked out, and it's gonna be happening soon, man. But yeah.
Thy land shall be divided by line, and thou shalt die in a polluted land, and Israel shall surely go into captivity of his land.
You see, so this is what happened to us, and that's what happened to you, man. You don't know, but the funny thing is, you know, you're going to clean it up, man. All these bodies, all these things that are going to be demolished, you're going to be cleaning it up, man. And you're going to be doing some handiwork, man. You're going to work with your hands, man. You're going to know how it is, man, to go out there, you know, by the sweat of your brow, man. Going through some things, man. Making big rocks into little rocks, man. You're going to be the new chain gang, man. You're going to be gang, man, Esau. And all of the heathens, man. You know, you're going to chain you together, you know. You're going to hate each other, man. You're going to be like, man. And you're going to see your daughters, you know, being sold. You're going to be sold, man, on auction blocks, man. You know, because you did all that shit, man. And you're going to be recompensed, man. Thus say the Bible. Yeah, man, you have some? What did you have?
At the mic.
I had also the oil.
For the priest?
Yeah. Because you said that they are empowered to do that.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. Can you keep joking? This is the book of Micah, chapter 2 and 1. Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their bed. When the morning is night, they practice it, because it is in the power of the head.
Yeah, man, so now, you know, these devils, they have their time, you know. These devils are putting out all types of wicked laws to trap us up with, man. To trap the people up with, and to come with wicked plans. You can read verse 2 as well.
Verse 2. And they cover the fields and take them by violence, and houses, and take them away, so that they oppress the man and his house, even the man and his heritage.
So yeah, man, they cover fields, man. Wherever they go, you know, that's what they are doing. By violence, they take your land, they take all the property there, they fight wars to proxies, you know, they put someone else there to fight for them, you know, while you think it's someone else, like the Taliban or whatever, they all be set up there, you can't set it, man. So we created them, now we're stuck with them, they gave you big guns, everything, man. You know, that's what they're doing, man. Letting other people fight for them, then they come in there and, you know, take over, so-called in the name of democracy. Our children, their jaws are being, you know, blown off, man, with all these bombs and all that, man. I saw pictures of footage even of Libya, man, when they were jumping in that land, man.
Yeah.
You know, when Obama, y'all prince, was at the rulership, man. Children dying, and they knew what the hell they were doing, man. Even before that, weapons of mass destruction, blah, 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 blah. We had people, veterans going to help the Jerusalem. A lot of Iraqis died, and it is what it is, man. And if for all of them that died, hey, that's your lot, man, because you did something that you deserve dying for, man. That's the punishment that the Most High gave you, man. But still, it still adds to the rap sheet of Esau. That's the beautiful part, man. Esau's gonna be punished for all the bloodshedding that he has, done until this day, man. And he continues to do that by putting out all time. It's not only warfare, man. By picking up a weapon, it's also putting things in your mouth. You know that the warfare, the spiritual warfare. Don't forget about that. No, that's why we break it down these strongholds, man. That's why we break it down strongholds, man. You know, this. If you can get that later, to the 2 Corinthians.
Yeah, I was thinking about it.
This is from Micah, chapter 2, verse 3.
Verse 2.
And they covered fields and take them by violence, and houses and take them away. So they oppress a man and his house, even a man and his heritage.
Yeah, man, these devils steal everything, man. You know, everything, man. Even a man and his heritage. They, you know, they claim to be everyone but the devil, man. You know, they're the Native Americans. You know, they are the people that they are Moses. They are our people, man. They are the Hamites. How can you be in the Israelites and the Hamites? You know, they're different forefathers, man. So what is this about, man? So you all types of people, but you ain't the devil. You know, who was being described as one that has that lacks melanin, that is red. You know, even the name shows who they are, man. Like Esau, Shashua, ways the way is he. You know, you go on the sun, you catch it, you catch it. You know, even on vacation, you be like, hey, I can't be out in the sun, because or else the rest of my 2 weeks is done. Yeah, man, I saw something on the television that Edomite went to Jamaica. He loved that. Benjamites to come over there to serve him. You know, of course in the shower. You know, nowadays you see protecting themselves better and better. But the funny thing is, if you take a look at what they are putting on their body, you see that it's dark. You know, you have a Nivea, or Nivea, as they say here, in the Netherlands commercial, where they see, I don't know what kind of glass they use, what kind of lens.
You fade it.
And you see that they rub the sunblock on and it's dark. So guess what they're emulating, man? But you can't be us. That's the whole thing.
They also do that thing with the spray that they come out all orange.
Yeah, man. Oompa Loompas, man. That's what it is, man. And same thing with the bodybuilding shows. What do? They tan themselves up to be like, sometimes, is that a jig? And you see, nah, man. Take a look at his hair. You know? You can see the features like hey, that's a damn Edomite, man. But they have to put on this standing. And same thing with the steroids, man. Who are you trying to emulate, man? Because Jake is naturally, you know, they have their build, especially now, of course, it's a little diminished, but most of them, when you look at the waist, you already grow. You know? Yeah, man, one nation shall be stronger than the other, man. We are more blessed than y'all, man. That's what it is, man. Yes, we are in your hands right now. Why? Because the Most High did so, man. And that's also according to the Book of Lamentation, where we're going to go into in a minute. But yeah, man,
Ephesians.
Ephesians, yeah.
I have it. Yeah, this is Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12.
weekend?
Yeah.
This is Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness, of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yeah, man. So it's people that are ruling according to the left hand side, man. And they deal with spirits, man. Can you go to Ephesians 2?
It's the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 10, verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we will not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty to Yahweh, pulling down our strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of Yahweh Basham Yahushai, and bring it into captivity every thought to the obedience of Yahushai.
Yeah, man, so we're teaching the word, man. We're breaking all these damn philosophies that Isa put out there as so-called, being science, falsely so-called. Science is to know, man. This is true knowledge, man. This is true knowledge here. You know, through spirit, we get the knowledge and by reading, man, by studying, man. You know? So we're breaking down all these strongholds, all these philosophies, you know, their tongue is walking through the earth because their bullshit is going left and right, man. And people believe in that shit, man. That you have carbon dating, which based upon, it has no foundation, man. It's just, this is what it is. It's a theory, man. It's so many billions of years old. How do you know that, man? Damn idiot. Weren't you a monkey back then?
That's right.
Oh, unbelievable. Sometimes we think about this shit, man. And that's another shit that is, you know, that's total nonsense, man. These devils, man. It's too much.
You get exposed left and right.
Man. If you lie, you need to, remember a lot of things, man. And that's not the strongest point on you, devil. You know? Of course, certain devils are lying and they, fucking up people by, telling different stories. But a lot of y'all lies is just because you don't know what the hell y'all doing, man. Mm-hmm. You lie because it's in your spirit, man. Mm-hmm. So then what did they say, man? Oh, shit, man, fuck it. Okay. We hear this press conference. Damn, man. It's the same shot, but now he said, you don't have to get these other shots, but you say you have to get them.
And now it works.
But what's going on? Because the boost shot is the same shot as the previous shots, right?
Yeah, we have no answer to that. We don't know that.
So you don't know what the hell's going on, but yet you're feeding the people this shit?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Yeah, this thing,
it's gonna be good.
Yeah, man. Unbelievable, man. But yeah, man, we finding also, Esau's finding also to the left hand side, man. But the left hand side is like, hey, man, this guy is true, man. And you see, it's diminishing, man.
They're dumping up each other, man.
Yeah, man, they're fighting each other too, man. And that's that the Daniel, man. That, the toes. Bible belt.
Yeah,
that's a
lot of people that don't believe in the Most High that are out there protesting, man. You know, that because if they have some sense, they wouldn't have that dog, you know, on their ass right there, man, going viral. That's good for them devils, man. It's good for them. That's what they were doing to Jake, man. But
I have a precept for you. This is 1 Timothy 6:20. Oh Timothy, keep that which is committed to thy trust, avoiding profane and vain babblings and opposition of science, falsely so called.
Yeah, man, the oppositions, you see? The oppositions of science, falsely so called, because they say, yeah, according to 3 million years ago, according to, Darwin and all that shit, which was on his deathbed, that was said, you know, that he was sorry for all that shit, man.
All kind of wicked shit, and when they die, then they're afraid, you know?
Yeah, they have remorse.
Then they're like, shit, there might be something when I die, you know?
Yeah, man.
It was also with an old witch from Emmett Till.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
And she also committed.
That old witch that falsely accused Emmett Till, she came up with the confession, and hey, man.
Yeah,
that is a filthy thing to do, man.
Years, man, she held the mountain.
Yeah, man. People were. That's how you see, man. These devils can't be trusted. People were grieved by that, the whole thing. If you see the image of Emmett Till, it's horrible, man. But that's what you're gonna see, man. You know, that female and the monster, involved in that, man. Even though, you know, judgment is coming off the Most High, but still, you're gonna pay for touching the apple of his eye, man. If you touch one of the Israelites, man, as a heathen, even with King David, and when that Amalekite slew King Saul, and he was coming back, you know, to say that, hey, man, King David was like, hey, man, this the bull of the death, man. How dare you touch one of the Lord and King Saul, you know, King Saul threw javelins at King David every day, man. If you catch a javelin, the spirit, it's over, man. That's a ticket to the spirit world, man. So even there, you see the honor amongst Yasha'ala, man, which is now far to be found, man. You know, apart from the brethren that are seeking Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, man. Because a lot of Jakes be like, hey, man, fuck him, man. You know, they rather shoot him and take his shit than to, take his spoils and divide it. You know, instead of, or if they see someone, in some cases, of course, if they see either might messing with a Jake, they might do something, especially now because the spirit is roused up, man. Because, you know, that's also back to the curses, man. Evil eye towards their brother, man. It's all in Deuteronomy 28:54, man. But I wanted to, 2 Corinthians, let me see. But all flesh, not the same flesh. I wanted that one. It was, man. But if you can look it up. And it's also always with this also, the lights come on very late. But we don't give a damn. You just keep on. Thessalonians,
was Ephesians 2, eh?
Yeah, verse 1 and 2. Because that shows you that, we are fighting a spiritual war against people that are fighting with, it's 1 Corinthians 15, I was thinking 2 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 39. So, we are fighting a spiritual war, man. This warfare that you can't see, man. That's why Esau tries to trick you into doing